Good morning, everybody. My name is Hideki Takada. I'm now working at the Green Finance and Investment Team at OECD, but I'm originally a secondment from Japanese Ministry of Finance. As you may know, OECD is an international institution based in Paris, and we have been conducting extensive work on green finance and investment to how to achieve the Paris Agreement's goal of a 2-degree target. And in order to achieve that, how to mobilize more infrastructure investment that is needed in the future. So that is the centerpiece of our work on environment and finance. And we are looking at the green bond. From the broader viewpoint, so how the green bond can contribute to our mobilization of the green finance and the battle against the climate change. So the OECD is not an academic institution, but the policy institution. So our work is not strictly an academic piece of paper, like other speakers, but rather the mixture of the policy discussion and analytical input. So please go on to the next slide. So just let me shortly talk about the context of our work on the green bond. So as you may know, in order to achieve the 2-degree target, we need a lot of investment in infrastructure, the green infrastructure. And we are conducting extensive work on that. The most recently, we published a report called Investing in Climate, Investing in Growth, as a response to the call by the German G20 presidency this year. So the key message of this report is that achieving the higher economic growth and combating against climate change is not contradictory. Actually, investing for climate change is actually accelerating the economic growth. And of course, in order to do that, we need a lot of investment. So our estimate is that to make the infrastructure climate compatible, we need $6.9 trillion of investment per year in the next 15 years. So we clearly need significant upfront capital. So next slide, please. So where is the money? Actually, the money is there. So we are not suffering from the shortage of money. Actually, money is there. So for example, looking at the institutional investors in OECD countries alone, they are managing more than $50 trillion of assets in their hands. So money is obviously there. But the problem is that only very small percentage of that money is allocated to green infrastructure. So our estimate shows that less than 1% of these institutional investors' money are allocated to green infrastructure. So the question is how to mobilize more money coming into those green infrastructure investment. And one of the reasons why we are looking at green bond is that green bond can be a very useful tool, particularly for institutional investors, particularly for channeling institutional investors' money into green infrastructure, which infrastructure is, by its nature, a bit of a different asset class for invest in, particularly for institutional investors. But the bond is a quite conventional asset class. So by using the green bond market, we can effectively channel more efficiently the institutional investors' money into those green infrastructure that is needed for the battle against climate change. So that is the motivation why we are looking at the green bond market. So next slide, please. So we published a report on green bond. It is titled The Mobilizing Bond Markets for a Low Carbon Transition. It's like this. So it's available from OECD website. So please download it if you like. So basically, this paper consists of the three segments or three chapters. So first, it overviews the development of the green bond market today. And the secondary, it reviews the various barriers for strengthening the green bond market and what policy actions may be needed to overcome these barriers. So these two chapters about the development of the market and also the policy discussion. And the third chapter of this report is, I think, a bit of innovative part of this report. So for the first time, we are conducting the quantitative analysis of the bond market development for financing green infrastructure. So basically, we estimated how the bond market will develop into the future in terms of the 2-degree scenario made by the IEA, International Energy Agency. So please, next slide, please. OK, so the first part, the development of the green bond market. So obviously, there are many rationales for green bond, both for issuers and investors. But today, I'm not going into details of this discussion because I believe these kind of things are more discussed in a later roundtable part of today's seminar. So go on, next. And the second part of this report is about the various barriers for the development of the green bond market and the possible policy options to overcome it. But again, I'm not talking detail today, so please go on next. So the quantitative analysis. So basically, what we are doing is, so first, we estimated the total investment needs. So how much of investment in a green infrastructure or green asset, low carbon asset, is needed in order to achieve the 2-degree target? So we estimated the total investment need in the future first. And then secondly, then what proportion of that investment is financed by the debt and equity, respectively? Really? So we determined so how much of this investment will be financed by the debt capital. And then among the debt finance, so what proportion would be financed by the bond compared with loans and other means of debt capital. And then we identified how much of that investment is financed by the bonds, and particularly by each type of bond, like corporate bonds, projects bonds, and ABS, and so on. And also, additionally, we made some analysis about what is the implication of this bond market development for the institutional investors. So namely, how much institutional investors' allocation of their money into those local bonds will increase in the future. So next slide, please. So this is the key result of our quantitative analysis. So we estimated the market development of the local bond from 2015 to next 20 years until 2035. So this is the development of the low carbon bond issuance and also outstanding amount. So please note that I'm deliberately using the word low carbon bond rather than green bond because we are dealing with the bond market in general, not only green bond. So actually, these figures may include the both the labeled green bond and the bond financing the low carbon asset, but not labeled as green bond. So this is not confined to the labeled green bond. And we are making no judgment about what proportion of the future bond finance would be labeled as green bond. So this is just one thing to note. And also, we are looking at only three sectors in the four regional markets. So namely, the three sectors, renewable energy and energy efficiency in building and low emission vehicles. But these three sectors will cover more than 80% of low carbon assets included in the IEA's 2-degree scenario. And also, we are looking at only four markets, that is the US, the EU, China, and Japan. And again, these four markets will cover almost 80% of the global the bond capital market. So we thought that well, these three sectors and the four markets where we can obtain relatively robust data, and also these are large enough to represent the general trend of bond market development. So the key result is that, wait. So the annual issuance of green bond sorry, the annual issuance local bond will increase to around 600 billion and 700 billion in 2035. And also, the outstanding amount of local bond will reach around $5 trillion in 2035. Next, please. So, more detail, what kind of analysis we are doing. So here is the total investment needs in 2035. So we estimated that total investment needs in low carbon investment in those three sectors in four markets will be $2.3 trillion in 2035. So how this $2.3 trillion would be financed? So basically, these are financed either by the bonds or loans or equity. And so we estimated that nearly 400 billion bonds would be used for financing the part of this investment. And also this can be broken down into each type of bond. But also these loans are coming from mainly from the banks, but banks themselves are maybe issuing the green bond to finance their loans to the corporates. So in that sense, these can be also called green bond or low carbon bonds or whatever. So we are calling it as a financial sector bond. So that these are issued by the banks. So just together this and this bit, we get the figure of total bonds about $620 billion. So this is basically what we are doing. Next, please. And this is the how the outstanding amount of bonds will accumulate over the time towards 2035. So the basic characteristic of our estimate is that the financial sector bonds, the bonds issued by the banks and also the ABS may make the largest contribution to the accumulation of low carbon bond. So our assumption is that currently, the ABS, the green ABS, only represent a very small percentage of the green bond issuance. But we are estimating, we are assuming that in the future, the ABS market will be revitalized and will play a major role in green financing. Next, please. And also some implication for institutional investors' asset allocation. So again, we are estimating that institutional investors in the future will allocate more money into those low carbon bonds. Next, please. But we should understand these figures in the context. So as I said, we are estimating that the size of low carbon bond market will be much, much larger than currently, but still very, very tiny compared with the total bond market size in general. So which also means that there are far greater potential for the bond market to play into the green financing in the future. Next, please. So finally, just let me take this opportunity to introduce the OECD Center on Green Finance and Investment, which we established last October, October and last year. So this is a new global platform for scaling up the OECD's effort in green finance investment across various departments in the OECD, and also the platform for strengthening our engagement with outside stakeholders. So we are open to engage with anyone in this room. So if you have any interest in the work of OECD on green finance investment, please come to us. And also, as a main event of this center, we are organizing annually the OECD Forum on Green Finance and Investment. Just most recently, we convened this event in October, which gathered 600 participants from across the world. So we are looking forward to welcoming you at the next year's edition of this forum event. Thank you very much.